I remember running home from school watching. Yeah, the cartoons are on.
That familiar funny duo ran into the hearts of many cartoon-loving kids and brought big smiles to an employee arriving to work Monday morning near the corner of Hiawatha and 32nd.
And he said, well, go have a look. And so I went out there and I looked and I said, holy buckets. I said, this is funny.
Cardboard cutouts of Wile E. Coyote and Road Runner appeared on either side of the Acme Foundry front door, a family-owned iron casting company started more than 100 years ago.
He put them on there with these little stick pads.
Employees have embraced the occasional comparison to the cartoon over the years, even have their own anvil on hand. It's a nod to sharing the same Acme name as the fictional product line featured prominently, but according to Jerry Bursch, misunderstood since Warner Brothers debuted the characters in the late 1940s.
Years ago in the early 1900s, Acme stood for the finest. The coyote is ordering the finest product you can get. And yet he gets foiled because he's a jinxed entity.
Partially because of the industrial location in Minneapolis, Acme is plagued by problems of its own, frequent graffiti. Then there's the prank calls.
We've gotten phone calls, is Wile E there? And, you know, no, he's not here.
But Monica Sweeney immediately saw this as art.
I love that he got him in motion, you know, and Roadrunner's made it by the anvil. The anvil's about to drop, and here comes poor Wile E.
She sent a photo to Fox 9 in an attempt to find and thank the unknown artist. By Thursday, a retired teacher stopped by to introduce himself and add an anvil above the door.
He's like, you guys don't mind if I show up at midnight and tag your building? And it's like, no, not if you do it like this.